What is good, YouTube world? It's Jay Coffee Talk tapping back in. And man, this one's going to have a lot of people mad, a lot of people laughing, and a lot of just reactions all over the place. As we all know, Trump has been, I guess, do they call that deplatformed? What do they call it? Someone hit the comments, right? Twitter X'd them out. What they say, Snapchat, Instagram, like social media platforms. I don't even know if Trump was using, but 50 Cent, Mr. Comedy on Instagram, always like, I'm always reporting on Fifth, joking around, getting at people via comedy or trolling, whatever you want to call it. 50 Cent always, seizes the opportunity when he sees it. And you see this post put up, it says, "No more Twitter, follow me on OnlyFans." And you see this picture, they edited together at Trump, and it says, "Damn, just don't forget to pardon a few people on the way out ish lol." And people are cracking up in the comments. But like I said, I know this is gonna have some people mad. It's gonna get a lot of reactions, and at the end of the day, that's what 50 Cent is always up to and trying to do. You know what I mean? Now, when it comes to Trump, I honestly don't really even know where 50 Cent stands. You know what I mean? If you guys remember, like prior to the election, Fifth shocked everyone. It was making all the headlines, like 50 Cent supports Trump because he was saying he doesn't want to be 25 Cent when he was talking about Biden's tax plan. He was like, "I don't want no part of it. I don't want to be 25 Cent. And then he was cracking all kinds of jokes and saying, "I don't need to see any of the other policies. The tax plan is what I don't want no part of," right? Because we know Fifth is involved in all kinds of different business, making all kinds of money, and he didn't want to pay all them damn taxes. But then I don't know, he was putting out other posts like after that where he was kind of cracking jokes on Trump. I don't know, he was just all over the place. And then there was that whole post that Donald Trump's son put up with Cube and Ice Cube and 50 Cent, where he edited like Trump MAGA hats on him or something like that, you know what I mean? But it was just an edit thrown together. And then Ice Cube came out and was like, "Listen, I'm gonna work with Trump, not for Trump." But here we are now, the election happened, the result is in. Trump, like I said, has been deplatformed, and 50's back to making some jokes. But what does everyone think about this whole situation? Like I always say, guys, I try not to really do the politics thing, because it's always a guaranteed argument. I always say I feel how I feel on different issues. I'm not the kind of person that I'm like, "Oh, like this is my, I'm with this side or that side." Like, I'm just me, you know what I mean? And as you see, all this different stuff is going on right now, and people are, at each other's heads arguing about all this stuff. But what do you guys think? In 6 months or so, is life gonna go on? Is everyone gonna forget about everything? Like, I'm just hoping in the comments up, I want to know what you guys think. And then I saw a post the other day where someone said, "Yo, they're deleting Trump's tweets from everything, right? Think about this. This is like history will be erased. It won't be an accurate account of, what he had to say when he was in office. They're erasing history. Do you see this?" And my reaction to that was, do you think this, like, did this have to happen for you to realize that history has been erased and rewritten many times? Like, this is the first time you ever thought of that? Like, you know what I mean? But I don't know. That's all I got on this one, guys. Hit the comments. It's Jay Coffee Talk. Always want to hear what you guys got to say. So let's talk. New viewers, sub to the channel. Hit that notification bell. Daily content. We talk music, news, sports, and much more. And I'm gone.